My name's Peter Birch, and I'm a product manager at Google in the Geo Group in Mountain View, where I'm the product manager for Google Earth. And I'm also an avid cyclist, so I often bike the... I used to bike to work every day, and then with Google, we had these great shuttles, which has kind of made it difficult because it's like a door-to-door transportation system. So I make up for it by trying to ride once a week from San Francisco to Mountain View, which is 45 miles. So I've also done a lot of cycle touring. I've biked thousands of miles in 14 countries. And as a member of my local advocacy group, San Francisco Bike Coalition, for over 10 years, I've been a longtime advocate for bicycling and transportation. As many of you know, the challenge that we face in advocacy is how do we get more people out on their bikes? And you know, programs like Bike to Work Day is a really great way for us to help our friends and our coworkers and share the best routes for biking in the safest and most convenient ways. But you know, one question is, how can we scale that up, right? It's not just Bike to Work Day once a day. It's every ride, every day. How can we provide that guidance to our friends and our families and transfer that knowledge in a way that allows them to feel more comfortable in doing those kind of routes? You know, a lot of people don't necessarily feel comfortable and familiar with the routes they're on, and especially in busy and you know, busy and unfamiliar city streets. And so, you know, what we want to do is figure out how we can scale this up so that we can handle every ride, whether you're going to the grocery store, or you're going to the beach, or you're going to the movie theater. Well, at Google, we love problems of scale. And we've done this before. We've done this with driving directions for cars. We've done it for directions for transit. We've done it for directions for walking. And everyone always asks us, like, hey, what about biking? You know, we want directions for biking. Well, I'm very proud to say that as of today, bicycling directions in Google Maps is live and available. So what it is, we're launching directions throughout the US, and this includes detailed map data for 150 cities. As well as over 12,000 miles of trail data that we've gotten through our partnership with the Rails to Trails Conservancy. And then over the next several months, we hope to extend that coverage as well as improve the quality of the directions that we provide. And with this launch, we're really showing our commitment to providing maps for people, not just for cars, right? In whatever ways that people want to get around, whether that's by foot, public transportation, car, or by bicycle. You know, and we're really proud to be a part of this growing movement of helping to build greener and more sustainable communities by providing this kind of a tool. We know that one of the themes at the summit is to promote biking initiatives both at the federal, state, and the city levels. And we're hoping that tools like biking directions can help accelerate biking in cities that are already great places to bike, and also help show the way for communities that have more to do in order to be able to reach out to their biking community and get people out on their bikes. What we're launching today is really just a start. We know that biking directions are only as good as the trail and road data that's actually fed into it. And that's why we need your help. You know, you guys are the experts in the best routes and which ways to go and, you know, which ones have sheros and which ones don't. And what we need is your feedback in terms of providing corrections, advice, and more information about which trails are actually the best ones. Because really, the goal here is how do we help in this goal of transferring the knowledge that you and your avid members of your communities have to the people who aren't necessarily as confident and experienced in where to go. So with that, I'd like to introduce Shannon Guyman, who's actually led the project for biking directions at Google with Google Maps. And she's going to walk you through a few demos and give you some more details. So Shannon.
As Peter said, I'm the product manager for the team that's responsible for directions on Google Maps. I'm here from our office in Seattle with a few of the engineers from the team that spent the last few months working hard on the feature that we're about to unveil right here this morning. It's our team's mission to provide the best directions from point A to point B. And over the last few years, we think we've done a pretty good job of that if you're driving, if you're taking public transit, or if you're walking. But cyclists have not let us forget that they haven't been included. I'm sure many of you have seen and probably signed the Google Maps Bike There petition that's been circulating online. Well, we heard you all loud and clear, and we've been working hard to make your request a reality. There are basically two aspects to what we're announcing today. First is the bicycling algorithm that we use to determine the best routes for cyclists. We try to optimize routes to prefer the places that you want to ride, and we try to route around the places that you'd prefer to avoid. What that means is that we weight our algorithm to put you on trails as much as possible, and when those aren't available, we'll put you on bike lanes or recommended streets. Then we balance that with avoiding steep hills, large roads, and busy intersections. We have, of course, updated our trip times to reflect typical biking speeds, and just like with our driving directions, you can drag your route on the map to customize it as you see fit, which I imagine many of you will want to do. The other important piece of our launch is a customized look and feel of the map itself to visually highlight the information that's most relevant to cyclists. We've drawn attention to the bike trails, bike lanes, and bike-friendly roads with color-coded lines on the map. So let's take a look. All right, so here we've got a map of the city where I live, Seattle. This is a driving directions from the University of Washington to Golden Gardens Park. So now what you're gonna see when you're in the Google Maps driving or directions interface is that in addition to our previous modes, you've now got bicycling available in the drop-down menu. In many cases, we'll also highlight bicycling in this also available bar for routes of a moderate length. So I'm gonna go ahead and click here. And now what you see is that my route has completely changed to take advantage of the Burt Gilman, which is a fantastic biking trail through the center of Seattle. Additionally, you'll now see those route lines that I was talking about. So you'll see there's these dark green lines for trails. We've got some kind of medium green solid lines to show you where there are bike lanes, and some dotted lines to show other routes that are good for cyclists. This category is typically routes that have been designated as good for cyclists in some way, but that don't have a dedicated bike lane. So that could mean sharrows, wide shoulders, or signed streets for cyclists. So for another example, when we demoed this feature to Andy a while back, he wanted to know how we would show his commute from his house to his office. So we took a look. And so you'll see here, this is Andy's ride, which every day, Andy? So except for when there's 2 feet of snow, Andy gets to take advantage of the WNOD railroad trail, as well as the Custis trail on his way into the office. And now let's say that Andy's not that happy with the bridge that we've chosen for him for some reason on a particular day. He can go ahead and click anywhere on his route and drag that over to the route that he'd prefer to take. And we'll update the route there in real time. This works for driving and walking as well, but we're really happy that this works for biking, especially because since we're now showing where the rest of the trails and lanes are on the map, you can kind of take a look and see where you would personally like to go on your bike and customize it for yourself. So just a few more examples here. I'm going to show you some of our pretty bike maps. Here we have Portland. You'll notice I don't have directions live in the screen. Instead, what I've done is I've gone to this button here that says More, and there it says bicycling here as well. That basically turns on this bicycling layer for the map. So if you're not interested in a particular route, but you just want to browse around our map and take a look at where some good trails are, this is a good way to do it. So here's Portland. You can see they've got a bunch of trails here along their waterway, a lot of bike lanes. Looks like a great place to cycle. My next example here is Madison, Wisconsin. Again, a lot of great trails and lanes here. Looks like a fun place to take your bike. One more example I'd like to show you is in San Francisco. And here I've brought up Street View. This is along the Marina Trail. The bike trail along the marina. And you can see that there are indeed cyclists on that trail, so it looks like we got something right. And finally, I just want to show you our landing page that we put together for this launch event. You can get here by going to maps.google.com/biking. And this is our maps interface, but it's got some extra information over here on the left. including a video with some more information. There's a link here that shows you how to get our biking directions gadget. This will enable you to put biking directions on your website. So we're launching biking directions on our API at the same time. We're excited about that as a way of enabling more websites to show biking directions. We're super excited about this launch. One important thing to keep in mind, though, is that it is launching in beta. We know we have a ways to go to expand our data set, and we're really counting on your help with that. We want to interact with these maps as much as possible and to give your feedback directly to us. So I'm going to show you how you can do that. We've got a feedback mechanism in maps, which will also work for biking information. And that's down here in the lower right of the map. You see this little link? It says report a problem. That can be used for problems or really any information that you want to tell us about. So let's say that in your community you're aware that there's a new bike lane that's been added to a street. What you want to do is zoom in to the street in question and click on that link. You'll get this little box and this little jumping pin. You just drag that pin over to the street in question and then describe what the situation is. So you can say there's a new bike lane between, you know, 3rd and 12th Avenues or something like that. And this will go into our maps pipeline and should go live on the map within about a month. We're really counting on this as a way for users across the country to be able to keep our maps fresh and updated. Additionally, I want to share with you all that we will be releasing Google MapMaker in the U.S. sometime soon. This is a powerful tool that's live in a number of countries around the world today that we're really excited about bringing to the U.S. when we can. This tool enables users to directly edit our map data, including drawing bike trails and bike lanes onto the map and correcting errors. So we think this tool is going to be a great way for biking organizations to contribute local expertise and promote biking in their areas. It's not live yet, but we will be making it available early via a trusted tester program. And we would like to encourage all of you to sign up for that trusted tester program, which you can do today out in the lobby at our demo stations. So now's your turn to try out biking directions on Google Maps. You can use our demo stations out in the lobby, talk to a couple of the engineers that have been working on it for the last few months. And you can also, of course, visit maps.google.com/biking on your laptops. We hope you'll share this among your friends to help encourage them to discover bike routes. And now I'll hand it back to Peter.
Thanks, Shannon. So, you know, I hope you're all as excited about this as we are. Google is a really bike-friendly place. We actually have bikes that are just distributed around the campus for people to be able to ride around. 1 in 10 of us bike to work. We have a really good showing for Bike to Work Day, where, in fact, I think more people from San Francisco bike in than from Mountain View, even though it's 45 miles. So we're really excited about this, and I'd just like to thank all of you for allowing us to participate in this. And, you know, to help in this mission that we all have, which is how do we, you know, get more people on their bikes. I think that's something that we all can share and work towards. So again, thanks very much and enjoy the rest of your conference.
I wanted to just ask Leah, are you going to come up and just play with this tool for us? Seeing as San Francisco has been featured so prominently, and I don't want you all to know where I live and ride to and from work. So what do you think, first of all? Pretty exciting, huh?
This is big. This is exciting. I know a lot of us signed that petition and are so excited about seeing this up. I'll say I'm personally most worried that I'm not going to get as much credit, wrongly, I will say, about going over all the hills in San Francisco. Now everyone's going to know you can actually go around those hills, which is going to be the big myth. But I think this is going to be a huge and powerful tool. I know in my community in San Francisco, 33% of adults say they want a bicycle for transportation more. And the things blocking them are really practical things, like knowing how to get to work, knowing where to park, et cetera. And this is the kind of very practical tool that we can help not only ourselves get around, who already love bicycling, but more importantly, bring all those prospective cyclists onto the street. So I encourage you all to go in, play with it, use it, and most importantly, let's get lots more of those good colored lines on there so we have more routes to recommend. So thank you, Google. Thanks to Peter and Shannon.
What about from an elected representative's perspective? What does the mayor of North Little Rock think of this idea? What does this mean for your public works director, for example? I think this might be on where you can use the podium either.
Well, I'll be happy to be here. First of all, let me ask everybody if you would, and if you've got a notepad, jot down 258 this past Sunday, which is, I believe, March the 7th. That's when my granddaughter, Savannah Lou, first rode without training wheels. Savannah's 7 years old, and she actually in North Little Rock has a trail named after her. So if you ever come, the Savannah Lou Trail is one you'll enjoy taking. It's out in our soccer complex. The other is the Isabella Joe Trail, and that's the granddaughter number two. Now, grandson number one came about a year and a half ago, and the Harper's Loop is another thing that you'll want to enjoy. Now, Andy and Shannon and Peter, I just happen to have a map of Pulaski County, Little Rock, North Little Rock, and I'd like to give this to you to ensure that we get up there and we get up there quickly. And I gave you my card, and our county judge, who's the county administrator, Buddy Valines. Buddy, if you'll wave, we're here, we're first timers, but we're longtime supporters. Of our trail system, we've been working the Clinton Library Bridge. The president announced that he's going forward with connecting that bridge. It's the southern end of our river trail system. I think many of you may have heard about the bridge that I know Andy had a chance to come down and we rode. North Little Rock was designated a bronze, which is the first medal designation in Arkansas. We're extremely proud of that. But this is exciting. I mean, we love maps and we love Google, and you put both together with the interaction that they can have. You know, the saddest thing I think we all have, and Andy came down this past fall when we rode around in our trail system, which is an exciting place, and people are just terrifically encouraged about it. We love the traffic. We love people out there. We love baby carriages. We love, you know, inline skates. We love pedestrians. We love bicyclists. And that trail is exciting for everybody to be a part of. And indeed, the old adage of if you build it, it'll come. But you got to know where it is. And if you if you don't know where it is, you're not going to be able to. And they're not always going to be somebody around, you know, like, you know, the judge or me that have a chance to take you on it. Now, I'm a bicyclist, and I have a great time. In fact, I had the judge created the Big Dam 100, the longest pedestrian bridge in the world that was built for pedestrian use over an existing lock and dam in Arkansas is the Northern Connection. But this is going to give us a chance to show people all over the world to come to Arkansas, to come to Pulaski County. But once you get there, for whatever reason, you're going to have a chance to be a part of what we think is an exciting opportunity to look at and to show and to enjoy, you know, the local scenery, and to do it without maybe having to contact someone locally to do it, and point out bike shops and other things where you can rent it. So let me just say, on behalf of one elected official from Arkansas, North Little Rock is excited to be a part of this. The sooner the better, if we're not already on the list. And all over the country, I can say I'm speaking for local officials. This is an exciting door-opening, event-shedding chance for all of you to know where the Savannah Lou Trail is, the Isabella Joe Trail, and Harper's Loop is. Thank you.